Today I want to show you the Madam So pressure foot set, and it has 32 pressure feet in it, so I think you're going to find it very interesting. Hi, I'm Kim Jamieson-Hirst. I'm an online educator and I'm the creator and host of The Quilter's Way. It's the only online quilting club that allows quilters to grow and learn in a fun, supportive community. Now, before we get into today's video, be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video. Today I'm looking at this presser foot set, and it's by Madam So, and it has 32 presser feet in it. So I want to walk you through what you get when you order this set and why I'm so excited about it. So first off, when it came to me, first thing I saw was thank you for your purchase. It's always nice to get a thank you when you buy something, isn't it? And actually, I didn't buy this. I must be honest with you. This was sent to me by Madam So for me to take a look at it and see if it would be helpful for me with my vintage sewing machine. So that's what I'm going to talk about in a little while. But first, it also tells you that you can go to madamso.com/instructions and you can find out information on every single one of these presser feet. There is also a DVD that comes with it that has videos on every single one of these presser feet. So you can use this yourself at home. And if you don't have a DVD player with your computer, let's say, some people don't these days, you can actually go to their website, madamso.com, and they have these videos for you to watch online. And I think that's really helpful too, because you may want to have your phone or tablet next to your sewing machine when you're installing and working with these presser feet. So you can certainly do that with this product. The other thing that's interesting, it tells you how to open the box. Now, the box fits very tightly. I'm going to show you that in a minute. And I like how they've got this little instructional card to show you actually how to open up the box so you don't ruin it. Okay? It's nice that it's nice and tight, and it's not that hard to open, but the instructions are actually kind of helpful. So then we come to the little set itself. So it's a little cardboard overlay, and it says here ultimate presser foot set. That's what this one's called. They have different presser feet sets. This one's the ultimate presser foot set with 32 presser feet in it. So now, because I know how to open this little box properly, I'm going to push down here. I actually have to move it off just a sec, but I want to push down near the little clips because they fit in securely. So you want to push down a bit and then pull them up. So what I'm doing is pushing down and then pulling them up, and it opens really well, but it's nice. They latch really tightly, so you're not going to lose any of your presser feet. Then when you open it up, it's a really nice little box, actually. When you open it up, it's got a little booklet inside, and it actually explains some of the things you'll need to know with this. I'm going to talk about these in a minute, but the thing that's nice about this is it shows you and explains every single foot that's in the set. So they're all numbered, and the numbers correlate to the numbers where they're actually stored. So number one is the invisible zipper foot, for example. So you can see all the numbers in here. And that makes it really easy to find the foot you're looking for. And of course, they all store in their own little areas too. So you can see some of these have their own adapters on them to get them on your machine. Some don't, and they need to use an adapter that comes with the set. So let me explain what I mean by that. Okay, so there's a bonus low shank snap-on adapter that you may need to use depending on the brand of your sewing machine. So if these feet are not going to fit on your machine, with the way most of your regular feet fit on your sewing machine, this is the little guy that's going to help you, okay? So he looks kind of interesting, doesn't he? He's got all these little things on him. Let me show you how he works. Let me take out one of these little feet here. Actually, I'm going to take out number 17 here. This is a stitch in the ditch foot. Let me move this out of the way so you can see better, hopefully. So you can see that there's a little groove here, kind of a little U-shaped groove, and you can see there's a bar on the foot. So you're just gonna snap it on, simple as that. And what I like about this, first off, I like how they snap on so easily, and I also like the fact that most of the feet are metal feet, so nice and sturdy, right? How do I get this foot off and get another foot on? Well, that's very simple too. There is a little red dot, a little red button at the back, you just push it, and it releases. So very easy on and off. Okay. But what I was really excited about when I saw this set, and what I was really hoping they would work for, is my vintage sewing machines, especially my Featherweight sewing machines. So I want to bring up one of my Featherweight sewing machines. I want to show you how these actually attach onto it, because that gives you so many more options than what came with my Featherweight machine. So I've got my Singer Featherweight, my 221 model here, and I wanted to see if these feet would fit on it. So I've got the low shank adapter on it, and what you need to do here, if I have a foot on it, take it off. I don't have a foot on right now, but I do need to take off the little screw that's going to hold the foot on there and get this on here. Now, the trickiest thing for me is lining this up with the hole on the foot holder. So let me just make sure there it is there. So just give me a second. I'll make sure I can get this on. Okay, I don't need to screw it in too far. Actually, it's gone there right away. So there it is. Fits on perfectly. Works perfectly. It's going to be really great. So I am really excited for some of these feet. I should say I'm excited to use some of these feet. I'm excited about the feet. Yes, I am. Can't you tell? I'm excited to use some of these feet. For example, this one here is a stitch in the ditch foot. So if I wanted to stitch in the ditch, which is the type of quilting you do on most quilts, I could do that with this foot. I don't have a stitch in the ditch foot. I don't think they made one. I'm sure they didn't for these vintage machines. So I'm excited that I could get that set and it has that in it. There are also some other feet in there. There's some pin tuck feet that I would think would be very interesting to use on this machine as well. So again, if there's feet in this set that I can use on a straight stitch machine like this, because this is just a straight stitch machine, there are other feet that you can use as well on other machines you may have. But I was really looking for a set that would work on a vintage sewing machine because some of the feet either didn't come with the machine or they didn't even make those feet for these machines. So I'm thrilled that this will actually fit on. It's going to work really well, I can tell. Let me just take it off again. So, you know, one of the concerns when you buy a vintage sewing machine is sometimes you don't get any feet with it at all. You could buy this set and have more feet than you'd even have got with the machine when you originally purchased it. So I hope you found this review helpful today. If you're interested in any of the products that Madame Sew offers, I'll put a link in the description below to their website so you can take a look at the other products they have as well. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to share it with your quilting friends. And remember to subscribe and hit the bell so you'll be notified the next time I have a new video.